First of all, thank you and welcome to new subscribers. And yes, if you subscribed because you were interested in a free reading, I just wanted to say, just a quick catch up before I do the reading, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, I am going to be doing some more free readings, but they will be a competition. I'm going to do 2 free readings at the end of July, and I might make that a regular thing. But I just thought it would be nice to do some readings that would allow me to reach more people, to help more people. So I've split these up in signs. So I'm doing readings for all signs and for the month of July. But what I'll do is I will look to see which of the videos has been the most popular. In other words, which ones received the most comments and likes and things like that. And then from that video, if everyone just makes sure that they comment under the video, when they comment they do mention whether or not they'd like to have a free reading. If you want to comment just for commenting, that's great, that's fine as well. But what I'll do is I will choose from the most popular video, I'll take all the names of people who've said they'd like a reading and I'll put them in a hat at the end of July, and then I will do 3 free readings which will be posted on the channel. So if you've looked at the free readings playlist and you've seen those, you'll see what I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about, and you could have one of those. Those are on display because they're completely free, and that was kind of the agreement. But if you do book a private reading, all the details are under the video in the description box. That is completely private. You get a completely private link sent to you, or it might be audio, or it might be on Skype. But either way, if you do book a reading with me, it is completely private. But if I do one of these giveaway things and you win a free reading, that will be posted on the channel. That's it. Thank you so much again for coming to watch the video, and I hope you have a fantastic July, and I'll speak to you soon. Hi Scorpio, this is your reading for July 2017, your Tarotscope, Angelscope and Astrological Overview. Okay, so Scorpio, for you, it's all about the ninth house. For most of July, it's about the ninth house. Changes in your belief system, possibly thinking about studying, any ideas to do with faraway places, connections abroad, anything like that. These things are going to be very much highlighted for you throughout July, as is the case every year. So, and looking at that in the context of the energy of Cancer, and which is about your emotional well-being, releasing the past, feeling comfortable at home. So it's possible that you're thinking of even moving your home, or you know, abroad or something like that. It could be that there are connections abroad that are just making you think, you know, I just feel called to experience a different way of life, a different kind of life. Could be something like that, or it could be just that you're thinking of traveling, that you're thinking of, you know, having a summer holiday if you're living in the part of the world where it's summer. But definitely being asked to examine your beliefs and think about how your beliefs are either helping you or hindering you in moving ahead on your chosen path. So let's just have a look at that, and look at any travel plans as well that Scorpio might be having at the moment. So movement, choices, decisions. Interesting that that comes up there, because that can very much be a card that's connected with travel. So there's definitely something going on there for you, Scorpio. I don't know whether you're thinking of relocating, or whether you're just thinking that you'd like to have some sort of adventure, but that's looking good. Okay, so we've got partnerships and alliances. So it could be connected with partnering up with someone, it could be connected with a relationship, it could be connected with just a new possibility for life, work, and things of that nature. And for those who are not considering anything like that, it could be just that you are thinking of expanding your range of experience generally, and you're having to make choices. You're having to make a choice between a couple of different possibilities that are going to involve, you know, some movement in your life, some change, you know, some decisions that need to change that do actually seem to connect with a partnership, or changing partnerships, or reassessing partnerships, or just really enjoying a new partnership. So it could be that you've met someone who lives abroad and you're thinking of possibly relocating because of that, or it could be that there's work abroad that you're thinking of going to, or it could be there's an alliance abroad, like you're working with someone abroad, or that you're working at home but for a company abroad. Okay, so let's start the clock. Okay, so let's see what crowns you. Wisdom, okay, that's nice. Rest and rejuvenate. So you're coming out of a period, a lot of you, where you've had to reflect a little bit on where you're going, because it looks as if maybe you were, I felt as if maybe you were sort of spinning your wheels a bit and not feeling that you were actually moving forward, and that the cards are saying there have been obstacles and challenges. So it could be both things have been happening, that you've been feeling as if you've been spinning your wheels and not moving forward, because things just keep coming up and things just keep getting in the way. And so you've sort of pulled back from all of that a little bit and thought, well, what do I really want? You know, just going to kind of heal myself, nurture myself a little bit. You might have even gone away, because I'm just seeing all of this sort of come to life, this nature, and it's almost like a country retreat, or you've started going for long walks or something like that. But whatever it is, it's giving you a good grounding from which to make some decisions about where you want to go next. And you're acting with wisdom, so trust yourself, because it does feel as if, you know, I've got this guy here, he's a monk, he's holding this sacred book and looking over at these people here, and obviously it's like he's made his choice according to what really suits him, what really serves him. He's decided to follow the path of wisdom, he's decided to follow a higher path, and isn't looking for any arguments with anyone, isn't looking to prove anything, is just wanting to be himself, and it feels as if that's where you are at the moment. Okay, don't look back. Once you make a decision, don't look back. That's what it feels like. It's like, oh, have I done the right thing? Have I not done the right thing? Just for a minute or two. And then it's like, no, I have to follow this golden light that's emanating from this book of wisdom, you know, which symbolises your true path, your true essence. And over here it's all sort of dark, and it just looks like an old energy, something old. Okay, and worn out, something you've outgrown. Okay, so obstacles and challenges you've had enough of. Moving into possibly a little period of grieving, possibly, but it feels as if it's something that you're choosing, because, you know, you've got movement, choices, decisions, and a strong pull to somewhere else or something else. You know, it may not be abroad, but it may be another country in the metaphorical sense, like, you know, another kind of realm of experience. And yeah, there might be a little bit of loss that goes with that, that you might have to walk away from something, or you might have to make a decision that doesn't come easily. It's not a big deal. This card is never really actually a big deal, because this person always looks in control of the situation. And sometimes we do have to make choices that will bring a sense of loss for a while, but then we can turn it around. Okay, so we've got here rewards and recognition. So this is your attitude, overall attitude. I feel you're not feeling that you've got that sense of recognition. And if you are, then it's only just beginning, and it's one of the things that's kind of pushing you into a new situation, like making you start to think, well, I know I deserve more. I know I deserve more than my current situation is showing me, and I want to be recognised for what I bring. It doesn't necessarily mean that you want to win awards, but it means that you definitely want to be appreciated and recognised for what you bring, for who you are. So, you know, It's just something to bear in mind that there is something in you that is a little bit frustrated, that isn't completely satisfied with what you're experiencing at the moment in terms of that. And if you have been receiving a lot of recognition and rewards, it's possible that they are not in the sense that you want to be rewarded, the things that you want to be rewarded for. So, you know, it could be that you're one of those Scorpios who's, well, I've achieved this and I've achieved that and it's great, that's really being recognised and that's really, you know, a sense of achievement in other people's eyes. But I don't know, there's more for me. I don't feel I've completely fulfilled myself yet. So, you know, I suppose it's kind of a card of ambition, but it's also a higher card that says, I want to be the very best me that I can be, and I want to make sure that I'm completely fulfilled while I'm here. So that's just your general outlook. Okay. And you're experiencing a lot of harmony in some areas. Could be relationships, it could be friendships, but it feels like, you know, the card is saying there is a lot of love around you, and that needs to be acknowledged. That needs to be appreciated, because it's not something that we can take for granted. Not everyone has that. So if you have that in your life, really, you know, give that a minute of thought and appreciation as well. Give yourself the opportunity to really appreciate what is good, what's really great, and focus on that for a while. Things are actually looking really good. So it feels as if, you know, if you're walking away from a situation that you're not completely sure of and it's an emotional situation, it's not saying, oh, you shouldn't walk away, but it's saying, you know, sometimes we have to step away in order to appreciate what's really great. It could also be saying that there's something in your environment that's shown you what harmony feels like, how it can be, and this is why you're possibly thinking of walking away from another situation, whether that's a work situation or an emotional situation or whatever. It's like there's harmony that you're experiencing that's making you want more from life, and that's great. Okay. Hopes and fears, mental conflict. So it's like there's a part of you that's really, really clear about what you need to do, about what steps you need to take, what direction you need to walk in, and there's another little mini me inside there that's saying, yeah, but what if this, and what if that, and what if you haven't thought it through properly, and what if that doesn't work out, and what if, you know, it's out of the frying pan and into the fire. It's that kind of energy. It's just constant questioning and self-questioning, and you're kind of wanting that to stop now, really, so that you can just enjoy the flow and the ease that you've kind of got glimpses of in a situation that's really quite harmonious. Could be, you know, this is a six as well, which is the sort of goddessy number, yeah, it just makes me think of Venus and that whole sort of energy of love and harmony and peace and beauty. And where you're experiencing that, you've got this contradiction here that's making you question it and question whether it can actually be okay, whether it's too good to be true. And you want the thinking to stop. No one's going to tell you yes or no. These are your choices to make. But if you continue along the path that you're on with this decision that you're about to make, let's see what the outcome seems to be. Light, okay. That's lovely. Whatever happens, it's leading you back to the light of your own being, your own experience. It's also leading you to hope and possibility and all sorts of things that you can't quite see just yet, because you're in this period where it's very much a mixed bag of, oh, should I, shouldn't I? If I walk away from this, I'm going to lose out on that. You know, it could be just a work situation that's just become a little bit toxic and you're just feeling like, oh, am I really ready to let go of it completely? But you can't see yet what's going to come in that's really amazing, because you're still very much in the vibration of the old. And as you move through and you get to that part that's actually like, it is a period of adjustment. It is going to feel a little bit uncomfortable, but it is going to be worth it. There's more clarity coming as well. I feel as if there are other answers waiting to come to you. And for you, Scorpio, you know, remember it's about the ninth house. So it is a great time for you to look at some of your beliefs about how things should be or can be in life, you know, and to just allow yourself to flow into something else if something isn't working for you anymore. And also, you know, with the travel plans, with all of that, if you allow yourself to walk into a new adventure as well, it looks as if there's much more light. So in other words, you could be somewhere that's not quite so bright, not quite so sunny or whatever. It's just not the right energy for you anymore. And then you move into this place where there just seems to be light everywhere and the environment is much more conducive to who you've become and you just feel much more happy and settled within yourself. So some Scorpios will definitely be making a decision to move abroad, and it could be that sense of loss is to do with having to leave family behind or, you know, something like that. Let's just pick another one. Comfort and defeat, followed by patience and planning. All right, let's just do your oracle cards. I feel that this conflict and defeat thing is to do with focusing too much on what you'll lose and not enough on what you'll gain. And also, please make sure that if it is a big move, like a move abroad, that you've done all the planning that you need to do before you go. Because it does look great, but it's not the sort of thing that you want to rush, because you don't want to have to be taking backward steps. So let's just do past, present and future, just to see what is, okay, great. What is the context for all of this change, this possible travel plan, and what is really July asking of you? So the past, the context, we've had a time of really good positive energy, positive people and situations around you, things that looked really good, possibly things that led to this recognition and reward, or this sense of recognition and reward, even though it's not quite enough for you at the moment. There's been a lot of positivity. Yes, there have been obstacles and challenges, but you've been able to overcome them because of the positive energy that's been around you. Where you are now is, watch your thoughts, because you need to remember that even though those obstacles and changes came in, that doesn't mean that you had the wrong manifestations or that you made a wrong turn or that your judgment is bad. You have to trust yourself again and make sure that you don't slide, because it just takes a little bit of time to slide away from positive energy and to slide to go helter-skeltering down, like really sliding into negativity. So watch your thoughts and bring yourself back to that positive energy that you were in when you first started some of the things that are really, you know, that you've outgrown. You know, the things that were really good, when they were good, they were really great, and you created that, so you can create it again. So stay in that positive zone, and then future. Okay, great. So it looks as if for some Scorpios, this pull in another direction is connected with a relationship. It's connected with wanting to connect with someone in a very deep way, in a more permanent way, or it's connected with wanting to connect with someone who's already in your life in a more meaningful way, and knowing that if you move out of the energy that you're in now, your relationship will deepen and grow. So it doesn't necessarily mean the end of a relationship. It means wanting to build the harmony in a relationship in the way that is most conducive to its growth. So putting it in an environment that's really going to work for it. For some, it will, of course, mean walking away from a relationship. But generally, it looks like a really good month of gaining clarity and being decisive, Scorpio. You are, you know, all about being decisive, putting a boundary down and just saying, right, that's it, enough's enough, it's time for change. So that's what this is all about. This card, I wouldn't worry about this conflict and defeat. I would say, I'm going to pick one more card about the conflict and defeat. So, just asking Holy Spirit guides and angels, what is the possibility for Scorpio to feel defeated? Why do they keep returning to this sense of fear? Okay, it's just not answering that, it's just saying stay optimistic. Oh, right, and that one fell out. So stay optimistic, your dreams are coming true, don't quit right before the miracle occurs. And then we've got the heart, healing heart. So you have been just experienced some kind of heart healing, whether it's a bereavement or grieving or some kind of separation or disappointment. And I feel that you're healing from that still. And that is the reason that your thoughts are sometimes dipping and you're not able to see clearly about this new decision and these new choices. So stay optimistic, Scorpio, because things can be better. Things are, good things are coming. Your dreams are coming true. And the only thing that can defeat you is your thinking, okay? So there you go. That's not real. That's what's real. Okay, have a fantastic month and I'll see you in August. If you'd like to book a reading, just click on one of the links below. And have a great July. Bye.